Fatihul Islam, President Shibai, Mr. Muhammad Alamir, Secretary of Technical and Madrasa Education, Bangladesh Government, Mr. Salahuddin Kashyap Khan, Bangladesh Employees Federation of President, Mr. Saiful Islam Mohinuddin, President, FBCCI, industry leaders, representatives of office organizations, excellencies, diplomats, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen. It's a great pleasure to welcome you to this event to share the benefits of running an inclusive business. I have firmly believe that inclusion is at the heart of ensuring social justice and an equitable society. All citizens need to share the benefits of economic development. Growth that is not inclusive can lead to deep inequality within the society and threaten the prosperity of all. That is why it is indeed heartening to see so many top industry leaders taking part today, as your involvement is vital to this cause. When it comes to inclusiveness in business, two groups among many can certainly make a major contribution. Women and persons with disabilities. We are all aware of the vital role women play in the economy of Bangladesh. While they make up around 90% of the overall labor force, the figures rise to an estimated 60% in the all-important government sector. Every RMC factory is full of women toiling long hours, producing the garments that are the lifeblood of this industry. Most work as operators, and very few ever rise to supervisory and higher levels. The glass ceiling to women's advancement needs to be smashed. Time after time, studies carried out in various sectors around the world point to the benefits of engaging women and capitalizing on their experience and potential to higher levels of work. Meanwhile, it is estimated that around 10% of the people live with some kind of disability. Unemployment among the disabled is high, with some 3.2 million people thought to be out of work. Any country cannot afford to miss out on this potential of such a large and valuable part of its workforce. I think it is fair to say that many Bangladeshi businesses initially hire persons with disabilities out of a sense of it being the right thing to do. In almost every case, however, employers soon speak highly of their performance, loyalty, productivity, retention, regularity in attendance, and overall workplace performance. As companies gain experience with more diverse workplace, the business case for hiring people with disabilities becomes more apparent. At this point, please allow me to mention the recently launched Bangladesh Business and Disability Network that brings together businesses which wish to make their workplace more disability inclusive. The network is supported by Bangladesh Employees Federation and ILO with the support of Canada. I firmly encourage all industry representatives here today to learn more about it and how it can help them. Ladies and gentlemen, while many companies are seeking to make their workplaces more inclusive, it is often part of an unstructured or ad hoc process. That is why this event that will showcase the commitment of three industry leaders from the Ananta, Bitopi and Shin Shin Group is so important. Their decision to sign this inclusive policy focusing on persons with disabilities and gender equality takes their commitment to the next level and gives a formal status to their inclusive business practices. I would like to sincerely congratulate these businesses for taking this bold step and look forward to seeing other like-minded enterprises in every sector follow your example. Allow me to recognize the efforts of the SEBAI, Center of Excellence for the Apparel Industry, for its efforts to support the development of this policy. SEBAI is run by an independent board consisting of dynamic players from the industry and overseen by the BGMA, with the support of ILO, Sweden and H&M. It is playing a valuable role in enhancing productivity in the R&D sector by boosting the skill level of workers. I encourage all industry participants to take this opportunity to learn more about SEBAI and how it can benefit the industry. May I end by also recognizing the excellent efforts of the current government, which has been very supportive of the disability inclusion. A number of practical and policy measures have been taken, such as the agreement by the Department of Technical Education and the Minister of Education on a 5% admission quota for people with disabilities in all given institutions. All of this inclusive business policies and the skills development are in the right direction, contributing towards continued growth and sustainability of the business in the R&D sector. I would like to also refer to the sustainability compact the Bangladesh government has agreed with the international partners, being the European Union, government of US and Canada, and ILO. I think the sustainability compact is another major support that you can take advantage of in continued success of the government interest in Bangladesh. I strongly urge other organizations and all here to forge stronger links with suppliers or with the planning institutions so that your future staffing needs can be met and inclusivity efforts are successful. Thank you very much for your kind attention.